An update tonight on a story we first shared with you last week from Hopkins involving a transgender student who says she was attacked in a school bathroom. At a school board meeting tonight, the superintendent sounded off as new allegations come to light and the district hires a third-party investigator. Jennifer Hoff, live in Hopkins, where that meeting is just wrapping up or still underway as we speak, Jennifer.
Chris, tonight we're hearing from several different voices. The Black Student Alliance speaking out for the first time after posting several statements on social media. But really, it was that school superintendent who was most candid at the board meeting tonight, saying and admitting what harm this has caused and how much work the district still has left to do. That's Dr. Rhoda Mirapuri-Reed, who says it has since hired that independent investigator to look into this latest incident that happened last week. When student Cobalt Sovereign told Care 11 then it started in a school bathroom after another student looked over the stall and called her a slur several times. Things then escalated and Cobalt says she was attacked, suffering a broken jaw and teeth. And since then, that Black Student Alliance posted on social media saying it's working to include all sides of the story, adding Cobalt used racial slurs, elevating the incident to another level. Now, I spoke to Minnetonka police. It tells me that all of these allegations are now part of the investigation, including whether a hate crime was committed. The superintendent also said that every student here should feel safe and says some measures already taken include teaching gender inclusion and anti-racism policies. There are also bi-weekly safety team meetings, all while Cobalt says she is still having nightmares.
We pride ourselves on creating conditions of belonging where each student can show up as their true authentic self. We pride ourselves on frequently meeting and addressing the holistic safety of our students.
I have received a lot of support from those around me. It has made this multiple times easier than it would have been.
Police have also confirmed that there is video of this incident that they are reviewing with both parents and students, so that is adding to the length of this investigation. And once it's complete, it will be forwarded on to the county attorney. The Black Student Alliance also saying that it will continue to support all students who are part of marginalized groups. So certainly a story we'll continue to follow.